Good.
That'd be him.
Oops, I sent that a little early.
And we are live with the pre-show. HorsePLAY Live Uncut. Episode 42. The mini of life and everything else.
I was playing with some people the other day, and they were like, well, you know, I had this raspy voice, and sat there and said, hey, dude, Obi, can you say I am Batman? So I was like, well, okay. I'm Batman. Does that really sound like him, really? It really doesn't, I don't think, but...
Fix.
I can do... Hey, I got my sick Annie down, too. You want to hear it?
Hi, guys. Sorry, I'm not feeling very good.
Yeah, that really hurts, too.
I'd imagine so.
All right, so we have that, 42, the meaning of life, and everything else.
Breaking stuff.
Who?
What's with it? Like, I can stream all day, but then when it comes down to the show, my ob is like, nah, I'm gonna act up.
Yeah, mine does that too. And I don't even know what's going on with mine. It seems like with all the settings turned down and turned off, I still can't. It's like it says to like high CPU usage. It's like, really?
Okay, now we're good. Yeah, it's...
And I don't even know what to do. I don't know what it is. I have no clue.
It's temperamental.
Do we do sound checks yet? Because I think I'm the high...
How do we sound, guys? I'm looking at the meters right now. You guys on the stream, how do we sound? Check, 1, 2.
1, 2, 3, 4. I might be a little bit loud, but I'm getting ready to fix my stuff right now.
I was about to get another pot of coffee going, and I was like, ooh, my stomach's a little tore up. That's probably not a good idea. Coffee and an upset stomach, not a good combo.
No. Not at all.
I think it's just because we had a very rich dinner. Delicious. But, oof. I know what it is.
I got retweeted. No, that's you.
Yeah. My tender age. Oh yeah, I gotta check the tweets. I'm finding that I'm less tolerant to chicken.
Oh, I'm doing it now. I'm getting on like 20 times a day on Skype or on TeamSpeak or on Jesus. On
Twitch Twitter. Starter Live just featured us again.
Oh snap!
It's a new shout out to them. We should give them a quick shout out.
We'll do that when we start the show.
Yeah. I'll put it in here.
I'm just doing it now because I've had people in the past, like, I'm part of Geeky Antics. Why aren't you retweeting me? So I go on like 8-10 times a day, and I don't care if they're from Geeky Antics. I don't even care what it's about. I just retweet it. I don't care. I'm not getting yelled at anymore. Why aren't you retweeting my stuff? I am! I promise.
Not so much, you know. People, you know, they like the loves.
Well, yeah, and that's why I'm, you know, if I'm not on it on my phone, I will be because yeah. Oh my god, why is it doing it again? High encoding CPU usage. Consider turning settings down. Everything's at minimum.
I don't know. Ops is being a butt munch.
And
we still got 2 minutes to figure it all out.
Right, right. Well, in that late, that one thing, that CRF, I have it to 25 right now.
You have to raise it.
We started it at 15, dude, remember?
No, you don't start at 15. 15 is high quality. higher number, lesser quality, better performance.
Yeah, but you had me start at 15, and then I went up from there, and I'm at 25 now. So I'm going to put it on 40.
No, 40 is too high. You can put it on 30 or 28. I'm telling you, 40 is going to look poopy. You won't like it. I would do it at 28. 25 is like the standard.
I'm gonna do 30 because I was raising it up and I was, yeah. And then because this is just a podcast too. So, I mean, it's not, well, I'm not saying, I don't want to say it like that because there are people watching, but still 30 should be fine. What was the other thing that I was supposed to turn? The process priority class?
Yeah, just keep that a normal.
There was something on here that I was supposed to turn on or turn up besides that little number. Maybe it was an encoding profile, maybe? High?
Yeah, I think we decided to keep it whatever you had before.
Well, you said high works better than main, right? For slower CPUs. Didn't you?
I'm trying to remember. It's hit or miss.
All right.
Because the main thing about that is which was more compatible with mobile devices.
Right. Well, I got Eric coming over tomorrow, and he's gonna clean everything.
Chewy.
Yeah. Wow.
Blue's taking over my desk here. Oh, it just got really quiet. Did you just turn off your audio?
I turned it. It was up at 100% again. I'm on TeamSpeak with GLG all the time. So TeamSpeak, there's not a way to make sure TeamSpeak will not take control of your mic settings for some reason. I can't find it anywhere. So I just had to keep turning it down. Now I'll go back to my regular settings, and everybody should hear me just fine.
Oh, yeah. Mine's a little up there. There we go. Say something.
Something. Hello. Welcome to this week's clusterfuck of the day. What's up? I don't know.
Sure, that works.
I don't think
it's 11:01. We should probably get started soon.
Yeah, we should. All right.
Are you ready? No rush.
I'm good, man. This is
the most interesting pre-show ever.
Yeah, it is. Let's go. I'm ready. Starting to stream.
People waiting in the chat.
3, 2, 1.
A little inside baseball there. All right, here we go.
Yep.
3, 2.
And welcome back, geeks and gamers. This is HorsePLAY Live. Today is October the 2nd, 2014, and this episode is entitled, it's episode 42, but it's entitled The Meaning of Life and Everything Else. Take that how you will. Our official intros and outros are always provided by TechnoX.com. It's royalty-free music. That's Techno with a K. You guys can go check him out. Guys and gals, I'm joined, as always, there's no fail, sick, dead, even in another state, he's going to be here. The favorite bear lizard of everyone, Yogi Zilla. What's going on, big guy?
What's up? Almost forgot to unmute my mic.
I know you did, because you're like...
Yeah, I was about to do it. And I was like, happening. Oh yeah, light's blinking. That's why I like to use that instead of software mute, because that reminds me, like, blinking light. I mean, that means I'm muting. I'm muted. Yep. OP. So you know, I just wanted to say that I've been a little under the weather. So today especially, I've been doing major catch up. I just uploaded the latest episode of AAO, by the way, OB.
Sweet. Just,
I think Obi's going through the same thing that I'm going through. We both got bugs that are trying to catch us or have already caught us in their grips. We're both sweating our balls off. It's particularly, I was getting spoiled. It was getting really nice and cool down here. And now it's so humid again. I'm like, stop. Come on, just bring the fall weather for good and winter weather. And I'm good with
it's
that.
It's really, right. It's really nice when you can actually go outside and go, oh, it's colder out here than it is in my house. I'm good. Yeah. And you can, if you're sweating or if you're hotter or anything like that, you can just step outside for a few minutes, cool down, come back inside.
Well, that's why I have the fan going, because I don't want to run the AC more than I need to. It feels weird having to run the AC when it's cool outside. But, you know, these houses, I don't know the way they build them, but they just either hold in the heat or they hold in the cold. But it's always like a complete contrast.
Opposite of what's outside.
Yeah, it drives me batty. But, you know, since I've been a little under the weather, I've just been trying to rest as much as possible, get my batteries charged up, because in 2 weeks, you know, Walker Stalker Con, I'll make sure I'm 100%. And there's a lot of stuff going on, and a lot of things in the pipelines, a lot of things we're doing to the site on geekyanswers.net.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of stuff going on. I'm not going to get into all of it, but, you know, this is part of my resting. I've done a lot of anime and TV binge watching, so if we get time to freeball, I'm going to probably share some of that.
Well, I finished my seventh season of Doctor Who now.
Nice.
I hate it that I can't watch it until it comes out on Hulu Plus or Netflix or something, because I don't have the channel, and I'm not going to spend an extra $35 just to get one channel. Ever. Yeah, I know. I'm sad. But, dude... If you guys are talking about the previous episodes, like season 1 through 7 ever, I will definitely join you. I just don't want to join you guys when you guys are talking about season 8, because it's like major spoilerville for me, and I don't want to spoil.
Well,
you know how River Song says, you know, spoilers, you know.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, she has their cute little things like her. But, no, Series 8 is actually pretty much halfway done. So, once we get to the off-season, we're going to definitely go back to older episodes, pick some fan favorites, and we're going to talk about stuff other than Doctor Who on Timey-Wimey Tea Time.
Right. Well, and I've heard the Timey-Wimey, I've counted it, actually. In the first 7 seasons, either the Doctor or... No, just the Doctor says timey-wimey 16 times. I counted. So how many times has they said timey-wimey in season 8 already?
I don't think it's come up, to be honest. Oh, well, yeah, it's come up a few times, but then he stops himself.
There was one episode where it was all 3 Doctors, you know, the one that did the bad, you know, blew up, you know, Gallifrey, and then the one that was season 6 and 7, and then the one that was with what's her name, the other Doctor. Well, I can't remember their names, but all 3 of them were in the same place, and they all said timey wimey like 3 times a piece in the same show. So yeah,
the big episode for me when he gets into the spiel is the episode from series 3, if I'm not mistaken, with David Tennant,
mm-hmm.
the 10th Doctor, and it's the episode called Blink, which might be Stephen Moffat's best episode to date. Blink is the one with the Weeping Angels.
Yes, don't blink. Whatever you do, do not blink.
I'm surprised they didn't call it Don't Blink, but they just called it simply Blink. Yeah, something more powerful with a one-word title.
Well, yeah. you could go a couple different ways with that. I mean, it's either, you know, use the blink as in don't blink your eyes, or basically, you know, really, Weeping Angels, they move within a blink, you know. As long as you're not looking at them, of course, they're not stone and they can come tear your ass apart.
Yeah. You know, and I love the Weeping Angels. I mean, they need to, you know, 50 plus years on the series. They need to expand the universe, introduce new villains, new alien races, new locations.
I hate Daleks. Sorry.
Daleks are great, but they're like,
I can't stand them. No shit. It's them, the Daleks and the
Cybermen.
The Metal Men, the Cybermen. Yeah. It's like they're in every episode. What? Come on, guys.
That's...
Do something different. I mean, on the episodes where they had like what was the one where it was Rory and what's her name?
Amy Pond.
Yeah. Ponds. Rory and Amy. Rory and Amy, they were staying downstairs, and there was somebody. It was not staying downstairs, but it was the doctor's roommate, the big guy.
Yeah.
That there was somebody upstairs, and nobody knew. Like, why would you? You're just not even upstairs on your house. Do more like that, because you have no idea until the doctor goes in there. You have no idea what's going on. That was the best episodes for me, is when it's not the Daleks, when it's not... I know we're like totally off topic right now, guys, but this is fun. When it's not the Daleks, not the Middlemen. I don't know what they're called. I just saying that. But not something that you see every single show.
Yeah. And you're a newer fan getting into it. Like, when I first saw the Daleks come back, since they brought the series back in 2005, I thought it was great. You know, it was like, I got all giddy. But then it's like, now it's like they keep doing it over and over again. It's like, all right, Daleks are great. I know they're always going to be there somewhere. But let's move on to other things.
Well, and that too, like the last time that you just, in season 7, when they blew up Cybertron, or Cyber, you know, the Cybermen's homeworld. At the very end, when the planet exploded, all you seen was a Cyberman's head. Floating around in space. Okay, they're going to come back then, because he's going to float around in space until he can latch onto something to upgrade whoever. And then there you go. There's the Cybermen race again. The Daleks have been in every single episode of season 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and almost 7. I mean, that's 5 seasons. Yeah, I've done a lot of research, guys. So that's 7 seasons that... Or, I'm sorry. 5 seasons that have had Daleks and or, well, anyway, let's get on with the show.
No, it's good. I mean, this is going to be, I don't want to say the banter episode, because people hear that and they're like, oh, is this going to be pointless banter? But we're going to keep it open, hopefully have some call-ins and just talk more liberally. We're going to have very, very light news for real this time. Not much gaming stuff even, but...
We're... Go ahead.
Well, I was going to say, I do want to remind everybody that, you know, I'm still doing the Blue fundraising campaign, and I'm sorry I haven't been doing the streaming as much every day as I'd like to, but as soon as I get back up on my feet, I'm 100%, I'm going to be doing a lot more streaming. BFT was with me last night, we were doing a late night stream, it was fun, and I finally went offline when everybody got, you know, tired, and like, alright, I'm tired, it's too late. But, yeah, that's pretty much it. But we'll come back to that depending on how much time we have towards the end of the show.
I'm dropping frames like crazy.
What?
I'm dropping frames like crazy.
Oh.
Anyway.
Yeah.
As always, we are also joined by Mr. Question Mark Man. We do want to make sure that he does have a say in everything that we do tonight. Question Mark Man, how you been this week? Pass. Okay, he's going to pass that on it. We do have one special person, one special group of people that we really want to shout out. We really want to get it said now. But shout-outs to at Twitch Starter Live. They feature our channel. This is the second week in a row, I believe, that they've been featuring our channel. So we just want to give them a shout-out. Thank you very much for everything that you guys just, you know, just retweeting us and featuring us. That really helps out a lot. We really appreciate it.
And they have a website, too. I think it's twitchstarter.com. So, it's another place where you can catch our show. So, yay!
Mm-hmm. If you are new to Horseplay Live, I can't do it tonight because I have no high voice, but hello! Horseplay Live is where geeks come to play always, and 9 times out of 10 get in trouble. So, This is what we do. We are a flagship show of our Geeky Antics network in collaboration with allgames.com. So if you guys don't get a chance to hear us or see us live, you guys can also get back on and go to allgames.com/chat at 5 p.m. next week, Thursday. 5 p.m. ish. We're not going to say it's definitely somewhere, but we do get a rebroadcast on that next week on allgames.com, so you guys go check that out too. Our show also, it all covers the aspects of geek culture, a special focus on indie games, strategy games, technologies, and social issues geeks face every single day while playing games or around games. And of course, what would it be? Horseplay wouldn't be anything without our rants. Some of the most epic rants that Yogi has, especially me, where we can just go off topic and rant about something totally that we're not even talking about. That's a special caster right there. Indeed. That's a special host right there, man. Special host.
Special as in short bus special or?
Either or, man. But anyway. As you guys do notice, we do lots of shout outs. That's because I lost my spot. We do a lot. Yeah, lots of shout outs. And we plug all our friends at allgames.com. And gang, why do you ask? Because fun. I'm just playing. Because we're all about community and we're all about collaboration, guys. If you guys want to shout out, feel free. You guys can send us an email or you guys can send us a voicemail. Voicemail is 206-415-4987. For those that are out of the country, it's country code 11. And then, of course, mail at geekyantics.net. You guys can both mail us out and even be a, you know, just a guest host on here. And that's any of our shows, really. So, Horseplay Live is every Thursday at 11 p.m. Eastern Time. You guys know that, 8 Pacific, on Twitch channels Geeky Antics and Yogizilla. So you guys can check either channel out. It helps us a lot anyway. So tonight on the show, we're hoping to get involved in some conversation. No real news this week. He promised. So when Yogi promises, yeah, let's go. He does fulfill. we're just going to engage in some real talk. Folks, just sit back and just stay a while as we explore life, the universe, and everything thereof. Wow.
It's a tall order.
It is, dude. It is. It is. Now, like I said, we don't have a lot of news. It's basically right here. It's two lines. So I do. Yeah, it is. I would like to, I don't know. Yogi, you want to do that real quick?
Yeah,
no, I'm messed up right now.
Yeah, I figured I would just mention in you know, obligatory news, two pieces. Am I doing both of the things or just the one?
Go ahead.
So two pieces of news. One is the gaming industry, the EGX, aka the Eurogamer Expo, recently went down last weekend. If you're listening to us live, but nothing much to report. I've been listening to all my fellow podcasters on 42 Level 1, B-Team, and other podcasts. And it doesn't seem like, you know, there was much to report. But that's pretty much this year in gaming. Like, don't expect too much in these expos and conventions and whatnot. But other than that, and it's gonna instead of Sundays at a god-awful time.
Wait. Don't say that yet.
Oh, now, okay.
The reason we're doing this, guys, is because you guys wanted us to. There have been several times where I don't have a guest host or somebody just, you know, no worries. It doesn't matter. But, you know, I'm by myself. Well, I was talking to Yogi and he's like, well, I told you that in the beginning, but, you know, it's okay. But we're going to actually move from 9 a.m. because nobody's up. And I know it was primarily for a EU competitive gaming and whatnot, and I still want you guys to come. I definitely do, but we're actually going to do it at 9 p.m. I know that's a total end of the spectrum for EU gamers and everything, and I apologize, but I think it's going to be better for everybody. As a whole, just because more people will want to watch at 9 p.m. as opposed to 9 a.m. And this is going to be fun. We're going to have lots of guests, guys. I could tell you all the guests we have right now, but there's right around 15. 15 coming. Not guaranteed, but we got more coming back, and we got some new ones coming, and that's all revolving around Dawn Gate and, of course, Worlds for League of Legends. So if you guys want to check that out, make sure you guys, not this week, but the following week, this Sunday is at 9 a.m., but then next week, which will be, I'm just going to get a date for you guys real quick, the 12th will be at 9 p.m., so hope to see you guys, and I think Yogi will be there every single time if it's at 9 p.m. We'll see. But we got a couple knuckleballer radios on all games.
I think it's better because I'm not a morning person, definitely not on a Sunday. And, there's Euro gamers and Twitch fans that are up late, 2, 3, 4 a.m. in the morning. So I think it works out better for everybody. 9 a.m. is just, oof, it's rough.
Yeah.
I need to have at least 2 cups of coffee to really be functional.
You gotta take your dump in the morning, too.
Yes.
2 cups of coffee and a dump. And a cigarette.
Yeah. If you smoke. If you don't, then, that's cool.
I was talking about you.
Oh, well, sorry. Yeah. Have I let you in on the morning ritual? Did I tell you that? Yeah, I probably did. Yeah.
Yeah, you have. Because I was like, where are you at? Dude, I'm doing my morning ritual. Leave me alone. I'll be there.
Yeah. Okay,
sorry.
It's my morning cleanse / meditation. That's what I do. And then I catch up on any social media stuff that went on overnight. Sometimes there's the really early birds or the people that were really busy overnight. I'm like, whoa, where does all this come from? But yeah, let's go on to the next section. That's it for the news, for reals.
That's it, guys. Now, that's it. I still can't do it, so it's going to be a little bit. I should have recorded these a long time ago, but I didn't do it. But we're going to try it. No, I'm not. Man crushes and geek girls. This is the guest segment, guys, where if you want to be a guest on Horseplay Live or suggest a favorite man crush or geek girls of your choice, contact us via Twitter, All Games, and the official gang website. Now, the Twitters are right above our heads at LB1X2 at YogiZilla, allgames.com/, I want to say, Horseplay Live, and, of course, our official gang website at geekyantics.net. So you guys go check all that. We'd love to hang out with you. For now, we do have some geeks of the week. Yogi, who is your geek of the week?
Well, speaking of All Games, I'll give a shout out to All Games Network Video. That's All Games, as games with an S, Network Video. It's a long name, but definitely worth noting, because you could go, if you follow them, you'll catch R9 Cast. They're currently the only show I know of that's doing video on that channel on Twitch. And they also do gameplays now. They're doing some more gameplays. So if you just go twitch.tv/network video, you can catch a video. And actually, you can also catch it if you just go to allgames.com and go to the live or chat area, depending. Usually, not right now, it's called the live area. You go in there, have the chat room option, and also the video player. So there you go. That's my shout out for the week.
Wow, very nice.
Very nice, very nice. And BFT says, by the way, with regards to the Sunday dose, he's like, yeah, it usually ends right when I could watch. Exactly.
Yeah, so, and we've been seeing that. We've been seeing it more of, people that really want to be there and people that really want to just be a part of it. Can't because it's too early in the morning or just whatever. So, but my streamer of the week is twitch.tv/pyroinsane. This is one of my guests. He is going to be my guest this coming Sunday on the Sunday Dose. He's of course, a console player and a Dawn Gate player. So we're going to get some knowledge from him on what he's going on. So you guys can go check him out. I posted him in chat there. Go give him a like. Go give him a look-see. He's actually playing some... Destiny right now. So go check him out. When, of course, after Horseplay. But yeah.
Is he a PS4 player?
Yes.
Oh, he should dual stream with BFT 9000.
I'll have to talk to him. He's one of my GLG buddies. He's always down to do some dual streams or, you know, whatever, especially if they're really good people. But we'll mention it to him though on Sunday.
Yeah, BFT is all about the Destiny, and he's actually been on our forums. He's been on our forums on
check that link out.
Oh no, I saw the picture on Sunday. It was great. Yeah, he's been to our forums on geekyanswers.net, and he was asking if anyone had PS4, if they had Destiny. I'm like, nay to both of those. God. But he makes me want to play Destiny a little bit.
Spath, I need you to make sure you send that to my, like, send it to me when we're on Skype, on my other Skype, my account, so I can get that on my clip art so I can actually put it up on my stream and everything sometimes. Because that's too funny. Because it started out, dude, Yogi, this is how it started out. It started out him taking my beard and put it on top of my head. That's all it started out as. But now I'm a pimp. I got a pimp cane. I got a, looks like a joint in my mouth. Got a gold chain. Got a fur coat and a fro.
Fro is
if I was born in the 70s or grown up in the 70s, that is what I would look like probably. Oh, God.
With a cheap knockoff kind of gold chain.
Yeah. Pimpalicious, man.
Pimpalicious. Oh God! I like the little stogie in the fur coat.
Right.
What does he put?
Hey.
Oh, Geeky Antics represent. I like that.
I got. Yeah. Do you see the microphone? I have a question for anybody. Let's just pick somebody out of the chat right now and just get them in here, and we'll talk. Get them in the rest of the show. How's that? Because this is our next segment, anyway.
Yes. We should still share that so people know how they can connect with us.
Yeah, we are going to. I'm saying it kind of silently so everybody can't hear it, so just me and you know about it.
Oh, the clown. I didn't see the clown one.
My telepath. Oh, I didn't want to see that shit. Anyway. Spathyzilla or BFT9000, if you guys would like to join us. You can join us today. If you guys do want to check out the, or if you're here live and you wanted to join the call and actually just be a part of the show, you guys can. You guys contact us via our Horseplay Live Skype account. You just search Horseplay Live, or you can search Geeky Antics and it'll come up with it. It has our logo, so it's us. But please use headphones. Please, please, please. We love to hear your voice, but we don't want to hear our voice in your speakers, so please.
You want to hear your lovely, lovely voices.
Wow. I'm Batman. So if one of you guys do want to hit me up, we'll actually add you to the call, or whoever does. But again, this is the Geeks Engage segment. If you guys want to ask us any questions, you guys can ask us on ask.fm or via email, of course. Reviews on Stitcher, iTunes, YouTube comments, we love them all. Please, we want them. We'd love to make more enthusiastic. We'd love to have more enthusiastic voicemails, as well as some bumpers of any show included, so you guys make sure you help out. We have a brand new show, Timey Wimey Tea Time and the Sunday Dose, and of course the other Sunday show, which is at 2 p.m., which is an Apostolic Outlook. I do want to say something about that, though, too, Yoke. My dad talked to me today.
Oh, okay.
And he is getting better on Facebook. He's very, very sorry. He's trying, which I can see that, so I'm happy myself. But he does want to say from everybody, Geeky Antics, he's already told me, but everybody, anybody and everybody that just likes to come in and just not listen to him talk, but listen and be somewhat enthusiastic about his show. I don't want to say experienced, but a seasoned streamer and sort of podcaster, I really appreciate it. I really thank you very, very much. You guys mean the world to me. And now that my dad is a part of the Geeky Antics family, he's just every day, he's like, really make sure that you tell them thank you. So to everybody, no matter if you're here live or you're listening to us on Stitcher, iTunes, or whatever, thank you very much. And that is from Reverend Ted Tarr. So, but yeah, that was kind of cheesy, but he says thank you very much. I'm a cheesy like, kind of guy.
I feel like brother better. Brother, it had more of a ring to it. It'd be like, brother love. Give us some love.
Mm. Brother Ta, tell us the word. No, because then people start, because I've already been getting tweets. Guys, it's not me. I promise you. He was live last week, and I didn't put up the YouTube video because Yogi had it up already. But he was live last week. It's him, I promise you. Yes, he looks like me, but it's not that. He came first, so I look like him. I just have hair on my face. He has hair on his head. We're different people, I promise. I've had people say, you guys sound just like, is that you, Obi? No, it's not me, I promise.
Oh, yeah, I put the AAO video up on our YouTube because Stan, when he misses it, he's like, where is it? So I do it quick. You take a long time. We take way too long to get it up.
Well, I had it going up on Monday, and then it was Monday evening. And I was like, wow, it's already there. I'm not going to mess with it. I'll make sure I get it up on Monday morning next time.
Now, TSD, I haven't seen it yet. I don't think you sent it to me yet.
It's there.
The audio or the...
Well, no, I just did the audio and then cut it, you know, did my trimming and everything like I usually do.
Did you upload the video as well? We'll figure it out later.
I don't do video with the TSD. We just do the audio podcast.
You don't put
I
it
just
up?
Send it, yeah.
I've been, oh, okay. I thought you said getting it uploaded to YouTube because I've been uploading it. Well, anyway, I'll get it up then. Most of our shows have a video version. So you guys go up to youtube.com/geekyantics. At least some comment love. And that includes Sunday Dose and Time and Mommy Tea Time, Horseplay Live.
Make sure you say in your comment, Obi, you're a dumbass, because that's my fault, and I'm sorry.
No, yeah, because I thought we talked earlier.
Because we just always, you did it basically because you took it off and I just sent you the whole thing. But now you said you just wanted the audio, so that's what I thought. You know, it's all good. We'll get it up. We'll fix it. Sorry.
I've been like, ugh, in pain. But I could have sworn you said you were going to, I thought you said, don't worry about it. I'm going to upload it myself. See, this is why you guys get an inside look. So if you're waiting for that video, you now know why. We'll figure it out. It'll be up by this weekend.
It'll be there, I promise. But there are more ways to keep in contact with us, guys. You guys can send us tweets anytime. It doesn't have to be during Horseplay or during the Sunday Dose or timey-wimey. It can be any time of the week. And 9 times out of 10, everybody else will tweet you back. It might take me a little bit longer, but I'm getting better. So please, you know, go ahead. Obi1X2 at YogiZilla and at question mark guy. Don't forget, of course, make sure you hit the at Geeky Antics. Yeah, it's not, there's really not a question. We need to make one just for that guy. Let's see how many people follow him. But you guys can also join us on our live chat hub at Geeky Antics on Twitch, of course, as well. Join us, the gang, the official HQ. I'm like all over the place today. Join the gang at our official HQ. Wow. GeekyAntics.net. I'm not fucking that up anymore, though. Comment, share, join the forums. We love to see what awesome geeks think all the time. And of course, for our latest content, Yogi, what do we have going on in Geeky Antics this week?
I just got up an article, a bit of a diatribe. It probably could have been 4 separate articles, but I just put a piece up that it was part to celebrate National Podcast Day, hashtag National Podcast Day, which was October 1st, but when I Googled it, it says September 30th, so I don't know, maybe both, you know, it was on the cusp. But anyway, you know, it's a thing where people try to encourage people to check out podcasts and support podcasts and everything, spread awareness. And a lot of powerful feelings there. We're going to get into that too today about, you know, how podcasting might be the last truly free media that's left. So I wrote about basically social media and podcasts and how you need to kind of do it with some sort of end game in mind. You know, you need to have some strategy in place, some kind of plan. and take action on it. So I talk about everything from the technical aspects to the attitudes and all kinds of things like that. I know that that's how that look. It's that article was long in the making. But by the way, what that's in reference to is that this is stuff that happened, and I'll share it. That's to put you on the spot, Obi. But you know, sometimes people they have contrasting personalities.
I quit.
And then
it does.
Things like that, and it's like, well, usually you say good morning, you put a smiley face. You didn't put a smiley face this time.
If I'm upset with you, I'm not gonna say good morning for one.
I was using a very abstract. What's going on? Yeah, I mean, but you know, so people read into things. They try to find problems. It's like we talked about Gamergate. It's like, yes, the issues are real, but then people try to find problems that aren't there. It's like, oh, that person said that term instead of that term, and that means they're racist automatically. You know, it's like, stop trying to dig for things that aren't there, you know? And I was just like, since we're hypersensitive, it's good to be sensitive, but don't be hypersensitive. Don't let everything bother you, and give people the benefit of the doubt. But anyway, you know, so I talked about the attitude things and how, you know, to create it, some tips on how to create community, and some of the issues that a lot of podcasters face, whether they're seasoned veterans or they're just starting out. So, you know, it's a opinion, you know, it's an op-ed kind of piece, opinion/editorial, but I also have some how-to elements in there. You know, I ask questions, I give everybody questions to answer in the comments. So it's pretty thought-provoking. Like, I started rereading it, and I'm like, it made me think more and more about stuff and where things are at right now and where the industry, you know, the podcasting is at. So that's actually going to be part of our discussion tonight, so it's a perfect segue. Right, Obi?
Yeah, right.
I think I just gave Obi some flashbacks. Like, I didn't want to think about that right now.
Guys, we are going worldwide. I want to let you know this is something that it's just amazing. We are going worldwide. But keep that in mind that when that our call-in line is for U.S.-based folks. Sorry. I'm really, really sorry. Well, maybe in the future we can get an international line to where everybody can call in. But if you guys would like to call in at any point in time, please leave us a voicemail, 1-206-415-4987. The number again is 1-206-415-4987. Or you guys can just, if you don't remember it, it's right there. Literally. I mean, it says VM206. Yeah. Your other way, Yoke. So don't forget, we will play and respond to your messages live. If you're shy, it's okay too. You can email us at mail@geekyantics.net instead, and we'll respond during the prospective shows of your choice. So there's ways to get on the show. There's ways to call in. There's ways to do anything you guys want to do. So we are still doing some open casting. We're looking for recurring guests and backup hosts for all the shows. I don't know if Timey Wimey is necessary. I think they probably are, but
yeah, definitely.
The Sunday Dose is, I know for a fact, and Horseplay Live, definitely. I'm still waiting for that one person or that two people or whoever is gonna call us first, but nobody's calling. They don't want to be on the show.
And Janelle's always here in spirit.
Yes.
Well, so is the question mark guy.
Oh, they might have to fight. That's gonna be a meme right there, Janelle versus question mark guy. Yeah. Be careful. Yeah, the question mark's okay until he starts to try to shoot the period at you. Then things get messy. Wow, that could really be taken out of context.
I did take it out of context. Wow.
I'm trying really hard not to crack up here because BFT, bro, he did a typo in the chat, and he wrote with the creepy guy in the can, and he meant to say van. And I'm like, I'm picturing a creepy guy in a can, and I'm like, oh, man, what the visual? And he's like, it cannot be unseen.
For our full list of exclusive and syndicated show, guys, go check out geekyantics.net/podcast. We are on pretty much every podcasting platform. Leave us a comment via iTunes, Facebook, etc. Wherever you guys see us, you guys see Horseplay Live or Geeky Antics, say what's up. We don't care where it's at. We're going to say hi back. So that being said, we're actually just going to move right along, right into the first quickie of the night.
But first, I want to say, oh, not yet. I thought it was already past midnight. I'm jumping ahead again. Oh, anyway, in about 20 minutes, it's going to be officially 2 weeks from Walker Soccer Con, more or less. Well, not exactly, but 2 weeks from Walker Soccer Con. And the reason I had to bring that up again is because, you know, for those that can't make it out there, you know, we could do a meetup out there for just gang as a whole, or for Time Wimey Tea Time, Horseplay Live. Some of the people from all games are going to be there. Some podcasts from other networks are going to be there. It's going to be awesome. I know it's short notice for a lot of people, but, you know, Obi's going to be on location where he's at, and we're going to try to, like, bridge the gap like that and teleport ourselves over to Obi's location. It's going to be epic.
Yeah. We're going to try.
So actually, that Horseplay Live, I'm still going to be here. We're still going to be in our normal location, but I'm debating if we could do, like, a bonus episode on Friday.
Yeah.
Friday night, you know, and stream it real quick and get everybody, like Sean Freeman and everybody in there. Matt Bradford's supposed to be there. Norma can't make it, unfortunately. So, you know, a lot of people can't make it, so don't feel bad about that. I have no excuse because I live in Georgia, so if I don't make it, I'm a real scrub.
You guys be ready for that in 2 weeks now, in 20 minutes. It'll be 2 weeks from Friday. You guys check that out. So hopefully we'll actually be tweeting. We'll actually be getting up, maybe setting something up. And we'll have, you know, hell, we might have 10 people in the call talking horseplay. You never know. So.
Oh, yeah, that's a good idea. Maybe we'll do a Google Hangout. Just make it like a little chill thing.
Yeah, and just do maybe a podcast or like a, I'll set it up to where I do a one screen some way, somehow, to where everybody's camera is just all in one, to where it's not really set up any which way. But we try to do it maybe. I don't know. We can try it out.
Well, I
think, see if it works.
I think we, you know, for that, we might just skip Twitch altogether and just do straight Google Hangout and do Google Hangouts on air. And it'll go straight to our YouTube channel. That's one way we could do it.
Yeah.
Because we got close to 500 subscribers now on YouTube too, as well.
Mm-hmm.
Though, if we could do Twitch and YouTube, that'd be dope.
We'll see what happens. Because I have a feeling that there's going to be lots of people streaming and getting that, because I mean every con, no matter what con it is, people are streaming it like crazy. So we'll see what happens.
We got some stuff going on in the chat too, and Stan would like to say that Timey Wimey Tea Time, which he wrote Team Time, I see what you did there, bro, encourages intelligent ladies with a little fashion sense, you know, because, you know, We need more women in podcasting. It's you know, and there's been a lot of talk about this, and we're about to get into this, but actually, you know, let's just jump into it, Obi. Open this up, and we'll get into it.
I'm not doing it tonight, quick.
Okay,
look at the.
I'll do it in Spanish.
Spatzilla is a freaking troll.
Oh my god, that I cannot unsee that. That is so.
I can't either, dude. You're a dick.
That you look like a crack whore in that Photoshop.
Oh shit, man.
We're gonna have get these up on like Instagram or something.
Alright, Smath, I have a job for you. I'll tell you after the show. Dude, don't spread that.
Maybe Andy can help us break into Vines in a big way. Or animated GIFs, at least. On Tumblr. Oh, by the way, follow me, guys. YogiZilla on Tumblr and Instagram. So, you know, stay tuned. If we do get some animated GIFs, yeah, it's going to be good. It's going to be good. But anyway, I'm gonna open it up, Obi, since you can't. I'm going to do the Spanish one, like we did last week, episode 41.
Ay, Vicky. Ay, Dios mío.
So anyway...
Amy Pond never stopped caring.
The what? Oh, Amy Pond.
You talk like shit Amy about Pond, Amy Pond. Amy Obi Pond. You.
That is. Oh gosh. The insides of my eyes are burning. Okay, moving on. So the title of this quickie is Beyond Brocast. You know, we're gonna look at the state of podcasting and what it means to us. You know, to Obi, myself, and to everybody in the Twitch chat right now, and whoever. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge might join us on the call. You know, I think Stan should join us. At least we have another body in here. Cause
I think Spathzilla and BFT9000 should join us like I asked them to.
I know.
If they were like diehard fans and they were supporting us 100%, they'd be on Skype already waiting for the call.
Well, to be fair, it's like 4 or 5 in the morning for Andy right now, so.
So?
But a reminder, the companion article to this quickie is on geekyantics.net/blog, and it is partly to celebrate though belated National Podcast Day. It should be a week. Having one day for that kind of thing, it's kind of weak sauce. But anyway, so just think about this, guys. What a podcast to you, and what does it mean to us as a whole? And I think it's important because there's a bunch of folks that we have in here right now that normally would not listen to podcasts, and we kind of broke them into that. So that's pretty cool that we could be a part of that. Hey, let's just make a show and not get any women in it. I think a lot of people have generally tried to make an effort to get women on the show and to have more diverse teams and casts. But it's hard because, I don't know, I guess it must be a certain kind of weirdo like us, like Obi and myself, that get into podcasting, you know. And I'm Latino, so I'm a minority, you know, that's a count for something. There's diversity in podcasting. It's just I think it's hard to pitch it towards certain people. Like a lot of women that I know, they'd rather do Twitch streaming than podcasting because it's a visual medium and feel like that will benefit them better. And I can understand that. But our video podcast as well, and it's a great thing to compliment.
Hi.
Exactly. It's a great thing to compliment your Twitch streaming or your blog, or if you're an author of marketing. You know, one thing I'd say is our podcast won't be bad. And what is let's talk about that. So typically a broadcast is defined by two or three dudes, maybe more, engaging in pointless banter and being very sophomoric. You know, might be a lot of toilet humor, maybe some misogyny involved. You know, it's like a frat party turned into a show. And yeah, exactly. Yeah, stuff like that. And I think that's the stigma. But then there's like, I don't think all broadcasts are bad. I think it's the degree to which you do those things. So like, as long as you have some structure and you're sensitive to your audience, you know, and you're honest about what you are. Like, if you make a show where it's like, all right, this is all we're going to be about, fart jokes and boobs and talking about phallic symbols or whatever, and that's the expectation you create to begin with, and that's what you want to be, cool. You'll attract that kind of audience, and, you know, that's your thing. And there's a place for that. That's not necessarily something that I would like, but, you know. So I think there's a good kind of broadcast, because there's shows where they have a bunch of dudes, they don't have any women on the show, and or they might have a woman that acts like one of the guys, and they get into the banter, but then they still have topical discussions, and there's a flow to it. And that's a good kind of broadcast. So I'm gonna play devil's advocate on that.
Right. Well, with like broadcasts and just regular podcasts. I mean, an instance is One Game, or One Gamer, OnGamer.net, which It's, I don't remember the guy that actually hosts it, but Monte Cristo and then a guy from Britain, I think. I don't know. But anyway, it's always two or three or four guys talking about this. I mean, they're, like you said, they're the good broadcasts are the casts that are actually talking about something relevant, not just talking about, oh, dude, did you see her tits, man? They were so freaking huge. Yeah, man. Hey, did you slap her on the ass when you walked by? Yeah, that, no. Everybody has their kind of cast where, you know, every once in a while we want to talk about it like that, but not with where you can get hundreds, thousands of people possibly listening to it. And if half of your people are women, guess what? You just lost half of your audience because you talk shit or you talk trash about, not even talking trash. It might be something, oh, I like big, whatever. It could be something that just women are just not going to listen to, because why would they want to listen to something all you talk about boobs? They have their own. They can do whatever they want. They don't want to hear you. But anyway.
Yeah, you know, and I think a reason that we see a lot of podcasts that evolve into a broadcast in the bad sense, you know, is because people start these shows essentially as a reason to catch up with friends. So, like, you know, that's fine. That's nothing wrong with that in itself. But you need to have some kind of structure, even if it's an unscripted show and you just speak from the heart. You know, because if your conversation is essentially something that you would have in private but not say in a public place, then it shouldn't be on the podcast either. You know, you can't hide behind these avatars and anonymity. What's going on in the chat?
Doctor.
The time zones are hard. Oh, I'm not looking at that right now.
Oh, my God.
I'm not going to look at it right now because I'll save that one for later.
Man, and do some shit to Yogi's face, man.
Spaffyzilla. Oh, listen, I've known him since close to 20 years. He's already photoshopped me plenty of times.
Well,
and worst pictures.
Like
a booger piece of photo.
Like, I just wanted, hey, dude, make me an overlay. So you're going to do all this? Make me an overlay just like this one, but it has Don Gate in the middle of it.
Oh, yeah, I haven't forgotten about your Don Gate overlay. I just haven't gotten around to it.
You can get it done. I'm still learning how to use GIMP, so.
GIMP sometimes gimps you.
Yeah, no shit, right?
I said I wasn't going to look. Like, you put Matt Smith and the TARDIS into it. Lovely.
Doctor.
But, you know, I think podcasting is such a special thing. There's things you can't do in video or with blogs that you can't do in podcasts. And the fact that podcasts are primarily an audio-only format, first and foremost, right? It frees you up to focus more on the content itself and some of the things that normally you wouldn't pay attention to as much because you're worried about things like overlays or your frame rates, you know, what kind of games you play, the high-definition graphics, or having the chibi of yourself, or, you know, so many different things that, you know, you have to worry about when you do video. Oh, am I going to fade in, do a crossfade here, you know? What am I going to do for the end of the video, like, to point people to other videos? There's so many things with video production. And blogging is even tougher because with blogging, and I still love blogging, I think blogs are very important, and always will be. But if you have a blog, it's hard because everyone can have a blog. You know, it's such a low barrier, you know, to entry. You know, so anyone can start a blog for free and just start doing it. But to be a true blogger, you have to really have a plan as well and do something special to stand out. But podcasts kind of lay in the middle of that between like a blog and Twitch and YouTube and all that stuff. It's kind of right in the middle, like the best of all worlds. That's what I like about it. So, you know, people say, oh, it's, you know, podcasts, you know, it's a tainted medium because all you have is a bunch of, you know, white guys talking about TNA and nasty stuff, whatever. That's unfair, you know. I'm not white. Well, I'm light-skinned, depending on if I get enough sun or not, but.
And I'm not white either, motherfucker.
This is you're as crack as they come.
It's just a light, man.
Obi's Casper the Friendly Ghost.
Look like Seamus up in this.
Embrace it. I think I was a ginger in another life. Cause I get when I let my beard really grow up, I get like when I let it grow up. When I let my beard really grow out, I get like rogue red hairs and blonde hair. It's really weird.
Dude, I got rogue gray hairs right here. Okay? All mine are like right here.
Oh, the gray hairs, that's fine. But when you have like random red or blonde hairs, that's weird.
Well, my hair is red anyway, so it's like... But well, yeah, I hear you. When you have like I have a red, dark brown, reddish beard, and then I get one blonde hair right here or something. It's like, what the... Pull it out.
Yeah, you know.
Night, zombie. Thanks for showing up, man.
All right, zombie. Thanks for stopping by, man. You see, I like him. It's late for him because he's in Europe, but he at least pops by. Appreciate you, man. But, you know, and we talked about those gamer gigs. Like, when people start, you know, it's like you try to identify a problem to create awareness so that it could be reformation, it could be justice or whatever. But then you actually aggravate things. Because saying that all podcasts are a bunch of, like, white guys talking about the same old stuff in a room, that's ignorant. And, you know, there's a wide variety of content out there. You know, you can't go through it through broad strokes. And I think we're seeing more and more diversity right now, which is exciting. So, later Z watches 6. Uh-oh. Dun-dun-dun. But, it is fair to, you know, I think it's good if you get into podcasts. If you've been considering podcast, yeah, the Godzilla Photoshop of me is great. That's an old one. But, you know, podcasting is a good reason to catch up. Yeah, we're not to put them up on the blog. But
coming this fall, Yogizilla in Tokyo.
It's a good Photoshop. But anyway, for those that can't watch video, sorry. Or they're not in the chat, you're missing out. Twitch.tv/geekyantics, by the way. But, podcasting, all right. Podcasts are a great reason to catch up with friends, yes. And it's a great way to make new friends. But also a platform with limitless opportunity. And I think the potential still has not been tapped. There's so many. Social media tools started incorporating ways to share podcasts and repurpose podcasts. Maybe highlight podcasts to make little highlight reels and gag reels and stuff. There's so much they could do. Like, give it the same treatment that Twitch has done, given video, that YouTube has given video. And the blogs have done with reblogging and doing micro content. And, you know, Tumblr is a good example of a different approach to an old medium, you know, or older medium. So, you know, so what is the purpose of podcasting? What's the value? What do you think, Obi, or what does anybody think? Real purpose of podcast. That was weird. You just zoomed in your face. I don't know. What the heck? Dude.
My camera's going crazy again.
Dude, what the heck?
I don't know.
The timing was impeccable because I asked you a question. I said, what's the purpose of podcasting? What's the value to you? And all of a sudden it zooms in your face and you have a serious expression on your face. I'm like, what the heck?
I don't know what the hell's going on.
Wow. That is really...
I'll fix it when I can, guys. God.
Everything's... Oh my gosh. All right, so while Obi's trying to figure that out, I guess I'll and it never ends. Which part never ends? Extreme close-up. Yes, that's the MTV close-up right there, man.
All right, sit back. Whew. We're good, I think. Maybe. I'm not touching it.
Okay.
That's what she said.
It works on the tech issues, but... So, you know, what is the purpose of podcast? It's kind of a loaded question because I think everybody has a different purpose. But I think ultimately a lot of people do start off, they realize that they don't really want to do video because video is very involved and it's a real grind. And it takes a while to do video and feel like you're getting some real results from it. Whereas with podcasts, I think there's almost an immediate sense of gratification and progress. It's easier to measure in some ways, the impact that you're having. And also podcasts kind of incorporate the old and the new because, you know, it has, you can make it a live thing and not have to worry a lot of the things that come with live usually, like Twitch streaming, which is, can be a nightmare sometimes.
Right. Have a thought? Well, and two, with doing streaming and then podcasting, like with what Yogi said earlier, a lot of people, and I'm just speaking from experience, because if the quality's low, I'm not going to stay. Even if it's a podcast, if I can barely see the faces and I, you know, and then that's, you know, that's why I'm so big on making sure that our video is halfway decent, because I would expect that, you know. Yes, podcasts are, you don't really have to have, you don't have any videos, so you don't have any lag there, but it does help if you have a good mic. So, I mean, it's, there's stuff on either ends of the spectrum to where you guys can, or anybody can start a, you know, a blog or even a podcast. It's really not that hard. One rule is you just don't stop talking. You know, have another person there, so you can always have something going on. There's always something being said, because that, you know, with how people listen to it, you know, if they have some dead air, if it's too long, I know there's people for a fact that if there's more than a couple of seconds of dead air, they turn it off because they think it's over.
Yeah,
you don't want that dead air. So, I mean, it's a lot harder to do video, and I could tell that to anybody because we do it every week. It's a lot harder to do video because you have to have everything in sync. You have to have, you know, if you don't have a good processor and you're streaming, even just doing a podcast, it's crap. I mean, there's so many things that you can and can't do with, or you can do with podcasting that you can't do with video. Unless you have, you know, a really good computer or, you know, a processor that's just out of the world, or, you know, not even, you don't even need a graphics card to podcast video. Well, you do, but you know what I mean. So, I mean, if I had to do all over again, would I have started podcasting instead of video? No, not for a second. Just because this is what I love to do. You know, there's a very fine line. If you guys want to do it, there's people to help. I'll help anybody I need to. Yogi will help. It's just, you know, if you want to do it, you gotta want to do video, okay? Because there's far much more work into it than just getting on, turning on OBS and hitting record and start talking. There's so much more to do with it, with video anyway. I'm looking at Popezilla.
Yeah, I saw that. So wrong.
It's funny though.
I'm probably gonna burn in hell for just laughing at that. Andy's trying to tempt me. Not taking advantage of your BFF. But no, you know, I agree to extent and I disagree, because I feel like production value is important, but I don't think it's as important as people say, because there's a lot of good looking Twitch channels and videos that are crap because they're saying the same thing, doing the same thing. There's no personality, no engagement. And especially with Twitch, it's a live it's a live experience. So it's more about the personalities and the experience than it is, oh, that's pretty pretty. A lot of people, they might pay someone to do a really nice layout, or they might exchange favors, quote unquote, you know, whatever those favors might be. I wasn't even saying that, but that might be part of it. But you know, they exchange services or whatever, you know, and then it's like they get a really nice layout and some nice, you know, custom graphics, and that's cool. But at the end of the day, they're still doing the same thing everyone else is doing, or they're not acknowledging their audience. They're not doing anything really special. They're not creating their own thing. So podcasting, I would honestly say that probably 80 to 90% of people that do Twitch on a, not on a full-time basis necessarily, but on a regular enough basis, will not succeed in podcasting because they don't have the personality and the technical know-how to make it happen. Now, videos are just more involved because you have to worry about all those other aspects, you know? But, that's what I would say. So I kind of mentioned that on the article as well that I wrote on GeekyAnswer.net. I talk about how production quality, I think, is overrated in a lot of times. Because you could blow your load making really high-quality videos for YouTube or getting your Twitch channel really fancy and getting, like, you know, top of the line computer rig and 6 monitor setup and all this stuff, whatever you want to do. But at the end of the day, if you're not doing something that's remarkable, and or you're just a douchebag, you know, or you're really quiet or boring. I mean, I say that, but there's a place for everything. There's an audience for everyone, because Andy, especially Zilla, showed me a guy that all he does is goes on Counter-Strike, and he opens up cases with random items in it, and then he does a little dance when he gets good drops in there. That's all he does. Opens up cases all day long. Shtick is, I don't do this for money. I would never ask for a donation. You know, I don't even want to be a Twitch partner. But he's got like a million followers, and he gets tons of people watching him. It's like, that guy's getting all this engagement, but like, he's not really that entertaining. But people like it. Like, I don't see what's entertaining in it, but, you know, everybody can carve up their own space. So, you know, podcasting is like that. If you stick with it, and you have a plan, and you stay consistent with your efforts, and you have some kind of like gimmick, or I don't want to say gimmick, because gimmick makes it sound cheap, but you have some kind of special thing that's unique to you, your own kind of formula, then eventually you'll stand out. But you got to, you know, have consistency to it. Mm-hmm. Obi?
Well, and that's, I mean, basically that's everything I was going to say, really. excuse me, like with what Yogi was saying, I don't know if you actually hit on this, but you did, but you could have like the best rig in the world and, you know, everything going, and you stream every day, and then blah, blah, blah. You get one person in there, you know, say you're just not quite the people person that you think you are. And I mean, for somebody to have a good stream and for people to continue to come back and eventually sub to you when there you get a sub button, or if you do, or anything like that, you have to be, I mean, you have to engage with your audience. If you don't, you're just screwing yourself. Providing when I get my everything fixed up, when I can start streaming again, we're going to be streaming quite a bit of Dawngate, and I can't wait, because I know there's a bunch of people that want to play and that want to just watch for a little bit and then play. I know I have to engage your audience. You have to. It doesn't matter if you do, and this is to me, okay, as a stream watcher and as a streamer myself, it doesn't matter to me how much stuff you give me or how much stuff you give away. It matters to me if you're talking. When I say, hey guys, what's up? If you look over at chat and say, hey Obi-Wan, what's going on? How you doing? That means a lot to me as a viewer. Because if I'm saying 10, 15 things up in chat and you're never talking to me, or you're talking to somebody else, but you never say, hey, what's up, Obi, or hey, what's going on? Thanks for the follow, or anything like that, when you know, people follow to you or subscribe to you if you have your button. If you don't engage, they're going to be like, follow, unfollow, because you don't talk. That's just, you're not going to talk, people are not going to stay. That's just how it is.
Yeah, see, and I feel with podcasts, it's in some ways much easier to engage people in more meaningful mm-hmm. ways, because when you're playing a game and you're making sure that you're trying to keep track of your frames and your stream, make sure that it's going through okay, and you're trying to play your game and try to play with some degree of skill or make it entertaining, and then you're trying to monitor the chat, you know, it doesn't matter how many monitors you have, you're one person splitting your attention in so many different ways. It's tough with podcasting. There's a lot of different ways you could plan for that and set up systems for that and make it part of the experience in more meaningful ways. And, you know, some people do that on Twitch, but at the end of the day, it still comes back to the games, you know. Like, you don't really see people go take, like, 20, 30 minutes just to, like, chat. Some people do. I like to do that. I take a little intermission and just chat for a little while.
Well, there are quite a few people, I'm not going to say this just because that's who I'm watching right now, but there are quite a few people that will play the game and do everything. I mean, you can do it, guys. You can watch your video and play your game and stream and engage. You can do it. It can be done. Now, you have to find your own self or your own time. You know, is it going to be, you know, do I really want to talk to people right now when I'm getting ready to die? That's on you. I mean, if you're somebody that can play and talk at the same time and then look over, glance over at chat, do whatever you want to do and still play the game, and you're comfortable with that, do it. I know they made a new, I'm scared to look at it too. Why do I have a cat? I don't even like cats, dude. Is that why you have a dog? what's wrong with you, man? Is that my gun in my right hand?
This article kind of covers a lot of the full gamut of everything, but you know, I think one thing that's special about podcasting to me, at least to me, is that what keeps us, you know, going, what keeps me going is at every step of the way you get some kind of feedback, and it always feels like there's some buzz floating around. With Twitch, if your channel isn't online, nothing's really happening. It's like a ghost town, and it's lonely, and it feels like an uphill battle a lot of the time. And it's poor design. It's how they've designed the platform. It's great in some ways, and in other ways it's terrible. It makes it hard for the newer people to really gain traction. And some people get lucky. Some people exploit certain things or use gimmicks, you know. But you know, if you don't have a lot of money to pump into it, and a lot of time to pump into Twitch right off the bat, you know, you don't live with mommy and daddy. You know, it's hard. You know, I would like to see more stories of guys that have families and want to do and are trying to do Twitch on a full time basis, but they also have other things going on. I want to see more success stories like that. Like I hear, all right. You know,
I'll make one then.
When yeah,
we'll
get there.
I already told you.
Yeah.
When I get my new upgrades for, you know, my computer that will allow me to do that, I will set up I will do a story on how, because I got my family, you know my schedule. It's crazy.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, we have to be, and this is something that we chose, you know, and this is something that when I married my wife, I knew. But, you know, we take care of grandma and we take care of aunt. Why do we do it? Well, we don't want aunt to go into a home, one. And just because we love them. I mean, very much. I met into it and she's like, well, if you don't want to stay with me, I know this is crazy, but if you don't want to be with me because of this is fine. I was like, can I help out? You know, I was like, I'll help out. You know, now I do it once a day for her at least at like 4:30. So she can spend she can have a breather. She can just sit down in her chair with her iPad or watch a show that we have on DVR or just whatever. She can breathe.
Yeah.
You know, I love doing that for her. Would I not, you know, would I have changed my mind in the past because I didn't want to help? Yeah, are we getting kind of screwed a little bit? Because we don't get to go anywhere. I mean, we got to be there six times a day. Mm. And if you're not there, you're in trouble. It's like one of those things where you have to be there. And people don't understand it. My life's crazy.
Oh, yeah.
I know, and then now we got a three-year-old that started playing soccer. So I go with him on one day. We go play soccer at night he's just, you know, a little learning how to play the game type thing. And then we have, you know, a bowling on Thursday night. And then we're going to be doing something else with my son. I mean, it's starting. I mean, I'm going to get hectic, and I'm going to do it. I guarantee you guys, will see me streaming soon. I hope so. I got some Christmas presents coming probably, and I've already, everybody asked me, what do you want? I just tell them, gift cards. Well, to where? Just get me a gift, like a Visa gift card. Because yeah. Guess what? I'm going on a new egg and I'm getting a whole bunch of new shit.
These are good. It's funny. A lot of places won't take the Amex ones anymore because of the fees they have to pay for those.
Yeah, they're like $350.
Crazy. But, you know, I know we're talking about podcasting, but just on that note, you know, when I look at a lot of the success, pretty much all the success stories I can think of right now on Twitch are all single people. That's sad. We need to see more mothers, more fathers, more family first people, you know. It's like so I can kind of see why people say Twitch has become a glorified you know, cam site or you know, social / dating site, because it's always like there's like that hope oh, maybe we could hook up, you know? It's like a dating site. Oh, yeah, Newegg is awesome. They've been having... We were talking... Actually, we talked about it last week. We're going to talk about it again tonight. How they've had some really awesome... deals for bare-bone computers and whatnot. And just computer parts, period. But, yeah, so that... You know, we'll wrap it up there. We'll probably come back to it again. I just feel like podcasting is in a better place. And it's more encouraging, more empowering to the artists. Twitch, it still has a long way to go where it could be relevant for the masses, or you know, be more diverse. It's very top heavy and selective. They seem to lean towards certain types of people, and I think that's kind of a shame. I think there's a lot more diversity in podcasting. You want to talk about, you know, broadcasting? You either have broadcast or you have Teeny Bopper Time with Sally on Twitch.
Casey Tron,
you know, and there's some one-offs. There's a lot of people we love, but there's a lot of stuff that makes you just shake your head. Like, is this what it's turning into? And it makes you sad. It discourages you. But podcasts, it keeps us going, man. You know, there's always a lot of encouragement, a lot of teamwork. You know, podcasters work more together than in any other kind of platform that I've worked in. Twitch, try to get someone on Twitch to collaborate with you. Oh, come join me on my stream, or come join me on my blog, or come join me on my podcast. It's like pulling teeth. They do not get social media. And that's a shame, because that's the kind of people they should be going for in the Twitch Partners program. See, now I'm going off on a rant again. But they should be looking for partners that are going to bring diversity and different kind of styles and messaging, you know. But anyway.
Right. Well, and the last question before we move on, too, guys, is something... You know, what keeps us going? That right there for me is there's two or three reasons just out of the top of my head. One is you guys. And I'm serious. I'm not trying to be cheesy or, you know, nothing. It is. If I didn't have you guys to say what's up, make funny pictures of me, or just talk shit, it would be like, you know, okay, I guess we're just not liked, I guess, Yoga, or, you know, maybe it's me, or, you know, what, but that's what keeps me going. And the event that, you know, the future possibility of, I know I'm going to be able to stream in the future. I know I have people that will, you know, even if it's not on Geeky Antics here, it's on my channel, I know I have people that'll come out and say hi and support me. That's why I'd keep doing it. Yes, have I had chances? I gotta get a part-time job for Christmas time, and you guys are gonna laugh where I'm actually gonna go get a job at. But I mean, anything and everything that I can do, and even just playing games with you guys. I know I got a couple of people. I know there's like at least two in chat right now that plays Counter-Strike CS:GO. We've been together. We've had a couple group games where we had three or four geeky gang members in there. We're playing CS:GO just. Half the time getting our asses kicked, and half the time we run through people. It's fun. I mean, that question right there, it's kind of a loaded question because you know we're going to say you guys, but that's it. I mean, that's why I do it. That's why I make sure that, you know, that's why I'm here on Thursday, you know. That's why, you know, Sundays and Saturdays, I'm not playing on Saturdays, and I'm not doing anything on the computer on Saturdays. But I make sure I try to be on Twitter and Facebook and all that stuff. So you guys do say something, I can tweet you back, or I can hit you back saying, hey, Gan, I really appreciate that. I mean, that's just why. Yogi, what keeps you going?
Well, yeah, and all of the above, and I think I've beaten that aspect to death. But, you know, I also like the fact that, unlike Twitch, which sucks when it's offline, again, I hate to knock this, because I do love the platform and I think there's potential there. But podcasting is just moving. To me, podcasting right now is better use of my time, and I like the results we're getting from that. But, you know, once we go offline, there's still going to be tweets going out, comments on our podcast. There's going to be all sorts of things going on, buzz going around, and momentum going from now till our next show. And, or, you know, whether it's HorsePLAY Live, Time and Wimey Tea Time, the Sunday Dose, whatever. And it goes from event to event. Whereas with Twitch, usually, unless you're one of the fortunate few, the one percenters, you know, they exist on Twitch too. You know, once your channel goes offline, That's it. And everybody goes to their next Twitch channel. It's kind of sad the way it's set up like that. They got to give more value to the offline content and the people that can't be there live but want to support you. Twitch does not empower those people that want to be there for you, but just because of time zones or their schedule, they can't. And podcasting is good about that. Now, we just happen to make podcasting part of our Twitch ecosystem, but this overall podcast, regardless of the platform, it's platform independent. You take a podcast wherever you want. If Twitch starts, you know, jacking things up further, or, you know, it's just we just decide it's not viable anymore, we can take it somewhere else. The people will follow us. You know, if your Twitch channel, you decide to take it somewhere else, you gotta start from you know, step one, pretty much. You know, that's kind of how it's set up. With all your videos that you had there, all the stuff you had set up, you know, you'll be able to move some. Anyway, let's move on to some shout-outs, man. Shout-outs and love.
Shout-outs and love. Why'd you line out the first sentence there? Because I wanted to say it. Did he give one already?
Oh. No, yeah, I just crossed it out on purpose because I know Stan, I don't know if you...
Did he give us one yet?
That's why I crossed it out.
Is that a yes then?
He gave us one, but I don't know where it's at, so...
Oh, okay.
I just left it there for next week. But yeah, Stan, I don't know if you updated the review you left for us, but it's still not showing on iTunes. Let me check. So for anyone that's leaving us reviews, if you're international iTunes store user, you might have to switch temporarily to the U.S. store. You don't have to change your address. You just switch over real quick and then leave us a comment.
Preferences.
Yeah, preferences, because Apple's really weird about making the reviews not show up from different markets. It's stupid.
Apple's still on the segregation train.
Yeah, pretty much.
It only ended 50 years ago, but you know, it's whatever.
Hey, Lucasio's in the house. Woohoo!
What? Lucasio's here?
Yeah.
Holy Nikes.
The party tonight. Time.
Where? Is she on your channel?
No, on Geeky Antics, man.
You might just not seen it. Guess not.
Throwing out some gang signs in the chat too. Oh my gosh, too many pictures. That's it. I'm not clicking them anymore. But just a quick heads up. I think we were on the top 10 on all games again, but Derek did not. I don't think he sent out the charts, the report this week. But last week we were at number 8. I think we're still around there, so that's cool. So keep listening to us live, and don't forget that we have a HorsePLAY live replay. Not really live, so HorsePLAY replay on Thursday nights at 5 p.m. Eastern. That's 2 p.m. Pacific and 10 p.m. in London, to give you an idea. And then we have Timey Wimey Tea Time. That's actually live on Saturdays at 12 noon on Saturdays, 12 p.m. on Saturdays Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, and 5 p.m. in London. So those are the shows we have on all games. And I think Derek H has been away because he hasn't been staying on top of the updates. But, yeah. You ready for the next feature? I think we covered all the stuff here already.
Sure.
You want to open this up? Obi's really distracted by the chat. What do we got? What do you got over here? What do we got?
Now my voice is starting to give out.
Okay.
So I'm trying not to talk at all.
Oh my gosh, I tried to give you a My Little Pony tattoo on this Photoshop's. Oh gosh. Hey, congrats on being engaged. Now, no wonder Lukasz has been cheating on us. She's found another love beyond our podcast. Aw. It's here.
For a long time, I thought she was pissed off at me because she just like ignored me forever. She's like mod of my channel, mod of everything. Good.
Everybody's pissed off at Obi. That's the ongoing
thing. No shit, dude. I'm just going to stop. I'm just going to vanish. See ya, guys.
Uninstalling Obi 1.0.
Uninstalling Microsoft. How's that?
No, don't do that. No, I'm not looking at the, no, I'm not looking at the Christmas. No, no. I gotta keep things moving along here. We're almost running out of time. But this feature. Should I do the hype feature? The feature. I don't want to get too loud. I don't want to blow out anyone's eardrums. That's just
you go ahead, man.
But this one's called The Meaning of Life, you know, because it's episode 42. You know, 42, the meaning of life, the universe, and everything. Come on, you guys.
I thought it was 42 level ones.
Oh, that's another one, too. 42 is everywhere, man. 42 is a good, nice number. It's a nice number. Flip it around, it's 24. You know? Fours and twos are just nice. They're nice numbers. But you put them together, 42, it's sexy. You know, clearly we can't get into the full depth of, you know, the meaning of life. But we're going to do a little real talk here. You know, go outside of our usual topic and talk about some emotional, spiritual type stuff, philosophical type stuff. And hopefully you guys will get involved. No one's taking us up on calling us on Skype.
I know, dude. It kind of hurts my feelings.
I know, they just want to do the chat. They're being shy tonight. you know, I don't really have any specific talking points. Just kind of speak from the heart here and just whatever you guys want to add. I honestly didn't know where exactly I wanted to go with this. I want to see where you guys will take it. But, so, you know, if you want to share your thoughts, you know, you could let us know in the chat, call in on Skype, wink, wink, nudge, nudge. You know, I'm YogiZilla on Skype. Or you can look at HorsePLAY Live or Geeky Antics on Skype. It should show up the same account. And join us live. Don't be shy. Or voicemail line. You know, 1206-415-4987. If you're joining us after the fact, after the live show. But, you know, just kind of think about this, you know. We spend our lives trying to find purpose, you know, trying to, whether we realize it, you know, consciously or subconsciously, we try to think about, you know, we try to seek that purpose, that greater purpose. You know, we might have purpose, but there might be something more that we need. We may not feel that fulfillment, or we may have happiness, but the happiness is fleeting, you know. It's kind of, you know, everywhere you look, you know, I look at my own life, I look at lives of my friends, it's like, I just stop myself time and I just, you know, I reflect on it, I pray on it, I meditate on it, you know, whichever way you want to look at it, you know, I just think, you know, there's got to be more to this life than making money and paying bills. And sometimes, like, especially in the first of the month, that's like, make extra money. Oh, I got some new gigs, I got some new projects, new clients. Oh, more bills came in. Yay! It's like, you can't make the money fast enough, you know? There's always more hands reaching for the money than giving you the money. And it's like, yeah, there's got to be something more than this, right? You know? So this is kind of like a message for everybody, you know? If you're in the struggle, just don't forget that there's people that care and they're there for you, you know? I'm going to get a little kumbaya on you guys. And there's some silly stuff going on in the chat, isn't there? We're trying to have a serious conversation here.
I'm Batman.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, shit.
Oh my goodness. This is what happened when you have the live show and you got really live people in the chat. But
I haven't seen Lou for like, sorry, I know, I'm talking I know. To her. I haven't seen her in like 6-7 months, so
I know.
She's less than an hour away. I mean, dude, she's right there and I haven't seen her in 6-7 months. So.
Aw.
Hmm. I think we're coming over there too. Me and my wife are going
to Sounds like where's Yogi going with this? The chat is in revolt.
Not even Yogi knows where he's going.
Sorry, where I'm going with it, guys, I'm going to be dead in 2 days. It's been nice knowing you. That's not even a funny joke. I'm sorry. That's terrible.
Hey, make sure you push.
What? Why do I have to go
somewhere?
Make sure
you push Geeky Antics to make sure you distribute it so we can still keep it up.
Yeah. No. That's what everybody cares about. Is it?
Make sure you pass the torch, man. We still want to keep Geeky Antics going.
We miss you, man, but we need to have the keys to the promised land. I don't have a place to go with it. I just said it to begin with. I just want to speak from the heart. I felt like this is what I felt prompted to share with you guys. I'm sorry if it's not funny and entertaining. Sheesh.
Well, better luck next time.
They can't handle the hashtag real talk, I guess.
I mean, either, but.
Well, I will leave you guys with one profound question then, since apparently this is not a conversation people want to have right now. They don't want to get into the deepness. But I ask yourself this, you know, would you rather have a life of accomplishment or have peace of mind? Are they mutually exclusive? My question for you guys. No, I'm not going to share now. You took me out of the sharing moment. They're blaming you, Obi. You led the distraction. See that? I'm trying to share some hashtag real talk here. Give people an outlet. Share their feelings openly. You know,
hit them with the distracting flex, son.
To know that we're not just charlatans, you know, joking around all the time. In Spanish, you say charlatan.
Well, no, we have serious conversation and topics all the time. You told me at the beginning of this show that it was going to be a, what was the word you used?
Serious? Huh?
No, you did not say serious show.
Banter? Yeah, but no one's on the live call. It was supposed to be a discussion. No one's taking us up on it. They're just chatting.
Why? See, this is the same thing chat's doing right now. You're blaming me. It's not my problem. It's not my fault.
I'm not blaming, but you guys were having a more interesting conversation in Twitch chat. So, you know, I'm pivoting. I was going to tell you, know, the whole discussion of meaning life, reflections of the soul, of what I feel it is, what gives me a feeling of fulfillment, and try to connect with you guys on one of those things. But we'll move on. Let's go on to some community events and giveaways. Do we have a reward unlocked that we talked about? We introduced here on HorsePLAY Live last week, and I want to make sure everybody's still aware. It's still going on. We're still working out the details, but over at Time and Wimey Tea Time, we are running the Soft Kitty song contest, whichever way you want to look at it. Yeah, same difference, right? Some people don't like when you say same difference. They say that's an oxymoron. It doesn't make sense. Whatever. It's vernacular and it's fully accepted everywhere. Deal with the colloquialism. Okay. But Stan has gracious. Pete's sake. But, you know.
Don't read chat.
Okay.
Just don't read chat.
But, you know, due to the insane international shipping rates, we won't be opening the contest internationally. You know, to pay like $50 to $100 to ship a pillow, we don't have that kind of budget. And I wouldn't expect Stan to pay for that either. It's not fair to him. But so it's only going to be available to people in the U.S. and Canada. We're still working on it to see if we can maybe do like some consolation prizes for people that are runner-ups or winners overseas. We're figuring out the details on that so we can make everybody happy. But we do have, on Time Warp Tea Time, it's crazy. We have people from all over, all walks of life that are really, like, leaving us feedback and getting involved and even leaving voicemail messages. I mean, people from, we have a guy that's called several times from Jamaica. That's crazy, I mean. So that's awesome. It's awesome. But details will be coming. Details are forthcoming on the giveaways page. I still have a lot of stuff to catch up on, and I'm feeling a little better now. Once I'm at 100%, I'm just gonna like drink tons of coffee, probably get like a coffee IV unit attached to my arm and just go full out, you know, crazy and just get everything done, spider monkey style, like rah, just get it done. The community has spoken. I know you guys would love more giveaways and we want to do them. So just stay tuned. We will have more stuff coming up. You know, everything's a little tight and crazy for us right now. You know, we are starving artists. I'm not ashamed to say it. I speak for myself. I'm a starving artist. I'm not sitting on a stockpile of riches. But, you know, we do have. I do have a stockpile of Steam games to give away, and digital stuff is probably gonna be easier for us as a whole. So again, as always, you can always find those things at geekyanswers.net/giveaways. Make sure you know you go to geekyanswers.net, get on our forums, on Facebook where we have Geeky Antics, the official site. We also have the HorsePLAY Retro Friday groups on. HorsePLAY is also /GeekyAntics on Steam, steamcommunity.com. And the Hearthstone group is still kind of there. We're not really doing the Hearthstone, the ye olde Hearthstone Tavern and Inn. But, you know, maybe we'll bring it back every now and then, a little newsletter for Hearthstone players. You know, it all depends on you. The more feedback we get from you, the more hype we get from you guys, the more inspired we will be to do bring those things and keep them going. But, yeah, keep the activity going on the forums. I know BFT has been busy there, King Deem, Stan's been there a bit, too. The more, the merrier. I think Obi's still busy with the chat. So,
yep, sorry.
We don't have much for deals for cheap bastards tonight. So, I did want to mention that I noticed that someone mentioning that... So I didn't notice myself. I've heard through Grapevine that Scott Pilgrim is part of the latest Humble Bundle. And that game is pretty cool, especially if you like River City Ransom or Streets of Rage, Final Fight games like that. It's got like that pixelated style art. Well, I know some people are like, oh, no more pixelated games, no more sprite-based games. You get some real graphics. But it's so endearing. It's a fun game, so... I I'm gonna have to hope that they bring this back on sale because I want that game, especially on the PC. I'll stream the crap out of that. But and also again, reminder, cause I know a lot of people are in the same situation that I'm in. You know, trying to build a new rig so you could get a higher quality stream and all that stuff.
Amen.
I've been seeing a lot of stuff on Newegg and Slick Deals for bare bone computers between $150 and $400, and this is bare bones. It means a lot of time they come with a nice power supply, like a high-end power supply, like either gold or platinum certified, which is important. A nice case, ATX form factor, so you have lots of room for upgrades and breathing room and everything. Nice fans on there with the case, a hard drive, motherboard, and a CPU, and then memory. And then after that, all you really need is a video card to get done. And you can get some other stuff too if you want, but you know, just to get started building a computer for just $150 to $400, that's better than a console. That's why Devin Creator people say, oh, consoles are cheaper. No, they're not. Cause even if the price, if you could pay the initial entry point, okay, maybe. But if you look at the long-term cost of a console, you know, how long it's going to last you, and you know, how much more the accessories and games cost, you're paying for that price difference long-term, and you're paying much more. It's like renting to own. You gotta spend a lot more in the long run, but I won't go on
that. Well, yeah. and a little thing real quick, I jumped on Steam real quick to Steam is just having a blowout right now, guys. If you do play Steam games, go check that out. Right now, Steam presents Paradox Publisher Weekend. Okay, up to 85% off catalog titles. That's the 2nd, so yesterday through the 6th, so yesterday through Monday, and it'll end probably around 3 o'clock or so Eastern time, so make sure you guys go check that out right on Steam. There's a crap ton of games right now. Democracy 3 is what it's called, I think. Yes, Democracy 3 is the weekend deal, and it's $8.49, basically. You're like the president, and you're running in the democracy through taxes and, you know, doing campaigns. You got to get the people to love you. And it's actually, from what I was looking at, when my buddy plays it or bought it, and he said it's actually kind of cool. So yeah, Guys go check that out. There are bunches of Steam. You guys got to be aware that I think in 2 weeks, I want to say 2 weeks, maybe three, Steam's going to have their end of the summer blowout. Now, this is going to be like what they did during the summertime. And now, don't quote me on this because I haven't found out for sure yet. But they're going to have a blowout to where damn near almost, minus the brand new ones, of course, they're going to have a blowout to where almost every game is 75% off or more. Like I said, don't quote me on it. I'll get some more information for you in the next couple weeks, or by next week, so I can actually give you guys the what's going on with it. But it's going to be the end of the summer blowout sale, so I'm looking forward to it. And if you guys want to, even if, you know, This is what me and Yogi do sometimes, and I know Yogi's gonna do it. But if you guys want to get anything that you want to give us to give away to a follower or a guest or something, of course, we're taking them all day long. Just say, hey, this is not for you. This is for a giveaway, and we'll keep it in our inventory. Matter of fact, don't send it to me. Send it to Yogi because he's got about 300 games in his inventory already right now that he's gonna give away. But, you know, send it to him. So, but it will be given away. I might do that here in a couple days. Spend about $50 on, no, it won't. About $25 on Steam, just buying some little games here and there. And especially the games that I have, because then you guys can play.
Democracy 3 sounds very good. Because I like Tropical, but sometimes I just want to get into the political aspects, like the simulation of that. And Democracy 3 is purely simulating the politics, and you have to deal with all the resource management and all the minutiae of details.
Right. Well, like I said, like you start out as just like a business person. Like you start out as a businesswoman or a businessman, and then you go to school, and you got to do this, and you got to do that, and then you got to, you know, are you going to run for, you know, you can run for office, or you can be just whatever, and you got to actually make it. You know, you got to help your democracy and your I don't want to say land, but your world, your democracy, you got to make it thrive, you know, by giving people better job, better wages, but hitting them in taxes a little bit. You know, there's just a whole bunch of things that you can do. I think it's going to be a great game. I'm definitely going to get it just to see what it is.
It's fun to watch people streaming that because it's something different. Like, there's just so many, you know, nothing against people that stream League of Legends, but it's like you see one League of Legends stream, you pretty much see them all.
Right. There's a couple other deals that we do have for you guys. GOG.com, and Yogi's going to put these in chat real quick. CheapShark.com, SlickDeals.net, HumbleBundle.com, and just for your for everybody to know that if you do go to Humble Bundle and you get something off their store, 10% of all proceeds from their store does go to charity. So we are very, very, very much behind that and whatever they do. The Origin, free-to-play games on the house, Ambandonia.com, CoolROM.com, BestOldGames.net, EmuParadise.com. Now, the last four, now we don't condone piracy or anything like that, but the last four sites, basically ROM sites, just go in at your own risk. I know they have really good games on those sites, but just be careful. Like I said, there some of them are where you basically just download the game and you get it for free, which, yeah, piratism, it's all good. But no, it's not anyway. Is the Bejeweled 3 still the game on the house game?
I'm pretty sure it is. I checked it last weekend. I'm pretty sure it still is.
It's not a two-week thing anymore.
They've been doing it for longer than 2 weeks now.
Have they really?
Yeah, because the Wing Commander was almost 5 weeks, if I recall. So.
Well, yeah. That was... Yeah, okay. Well,
man, Lukasha is really generous.
I'm double-checking.
That's awesome.
Very nice.
Humble Bundle is awesome. I wish I could give more. I feel so dirty sometimes when I give like I can't give the bare minimum, but I'll give like a little bit more. And it's like if they have unlockables, I'll be like, all right, I'll give you a little extra more. But it's like, this is gonna kill me. I'm gonna normally later. Right. Someone in my family will be like, I need this or I need that. And it's like, damn it.
But yes, the Origin. sorry guys, my voice is starting to go. The Origin game of the week, the free game, is Bejeweled 3 still, and that is going to be free. I'm thinking it set a date, but it doesn't. We'll just let you know. If it's changed next week, we'll let you guys know, but go ahead and check that out as well. Just because, I mean, it's Bejeweled, so I mean, if you've got a freaking Android or a tablet or something, you've probably played it or something like it. Or if you have any Facebook buddies that just troll the hell out of you and give you 23,000 invites a day, you've probably played it already. So it's just that But keep a eye on it, guys. There's some really good games, and I missed the Wing Commander, and I really wanted to get it. So, but keep an eye out on it, guys, because games come up. I know for one game they had, it was only up there for 3 or 4 days because everybody got it. I mean, the more people download it, guys, the faster or the shorter it stays up. Yeah. I do know that. So, but now this is the part of the show where, you know, we're not quite out of time yet, but we still like to freeball a little bit. Now, the question to the chat, and I'm sure Yogi will be happy with this. What in the last week, now listen closely, what in the last week have you guys seen that is either just super awesome or the most retarded thing in the world that you've ever seen in your life? Let us know, guys. We'll freeball about that. The one thing in gaming that you have seen in the last week that is the best thing that's happened in the last week or the worst thing that's happened in the last week? Let us know. But that, while we're getting some stuff from chat, Yogi, there is a couple things that I saw on here that we're just going to give a little bit. I know this is not, you crossed it off already, but while we're waiting for them to kind of give us some insight of what we're going to freeball on, what are some of the games that you've played this week, but you haven't said before? Like, you played Faster Than Light, I know that, but like, what other games have you played like that you haven't said before this week? I got a couple, so that's, you got to do it too.
Just a gauntlet, really. It hasn't been anything really new. I think at this point I'm just gonna be recycling a lot of the same games, and you know, I'm getting back into Hearthstone again. It's an on and off thing. Mm-hmm. For me, it's been less gaming and more anime lately. Like, I've caught up with Naruto Shippuden, and I love it. Oh gosh, I love that. That's one of my favorite anime series of all time. Ninjas and love and friendship. It's beautiful. Makes me happy.
Very nice. Well, you guys all know me. I play, you know, a little bit of everything. You know, Hearthstone, Diablo 3, Dawngate, and League of Legends. Well, there's been a couple games that I've had for a little while anyway, that I haven't played very much, but I'm getting into it now because I really like them. I really enjoy them. One being CSGO and the other being Payday 2. I know I've talked about Payday 2. We've done a video on a giveaway of Payday 2, which I haven't heard from that guy, by the way. Just to let you know. The guy that won? I still haven't heard from him. I've been checking everything. My Twitch, you know.
There's been some comments. People have been asking about who won or if it's too late to enter.
Mm-hmm.
Might have to do a redrunk. I think we said
last week. Back. No, it was last week.
Oh, okay.
But we're going to give them a week or so. So, or more. I don't know yet. But I really think I want to give this away. I mean, I want to get this out to somebody.
Yeah, I think we said 2 weeks. Because you're going to give enough time to listen to the show. Okay. So I think it's been already 2 weeks, so.
Was that was on episode 40, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Sent him a Twitch message again. A YouTube message from us, or maybe it was from me, saying, you know, hey, you won Payday 2, congratulations, send me your info, and nothing. So, providing he doesn't come up with us or talk to me this week, guys, we will be giving it away. You want us to just do it next week? Yeah, we can do it right now if you want to, I don't care.
Yeah, we can do it next week, give him another chance.
Okay, so this is another week, guys. We're going to give the other one. If you do want a chance to win Payday 2, go ahead to GeekyAntics, youtube.com/GeekyAntics. Go look for the Payday 2 giveaway and just leave a comment, guys, on why you would like the game. Whether it be I want to play with my friends or, you know, I don't know, whatever. So we will then give that away next week on live here on Horseplay. Does that sound good to you? Well, no, like I said, we're going to, well, he hasn't showed up in 2 weeks, so it's a redraw then, because that's what we said originally, is if he doesn't come up into the next 2 weeks, which it's been 2 weeks, we're going to redraw. So Now, am I saying it right? Right? I'm not. I don't want to confuse anybody, because you know, I've almost confused people before, and I wanted it to be fair for everybody. So, next week, the guy hasn't showed up, hasn't said anything. I've messaged him a couple of times. Next week, we are going to re-roll.
Yeah, gonna have to get a comment up on YouTube too, so people know. You know, that's what I don't like about YouTube and some of these other sites is like that people stay there, but it's like you tell them we're gonna announce the winner on our podcast, and then they don't come, but they wanted to win. It's like, well, it's not a so you know, we probably could have communicated that a little better. Well, you could have, Obi, because that's your baby. Is your giveaway?
Well, truthfully and honestly, and I'm not gonna lie to you, until Sunday-ish, I forgot all about it. I checked my messages. Well, I not forget all about it, but I, after a week of not hearing anything from somebody, you kind of, you know, like, did he call? Nope, no context. You just blow by.
Some more people have been asking about it. Like, oh, is it too late to join this? Or when is it being announced? So get a comment on there. Let them know when we're redrawing, what time, where. Get them over to the Twitch channel. That way they don't miss it.
All right, this is what we're going to do. We're going to set up right now. Yogi, is any time good between 11 and 1?
Oh, like during the show? No, they got to stick around for the whole show.
There you go. Stick around for the whole show.
I mean, you know, we usually do it
midnight.
Well, by the time we get to the community events section, the segment, it's usually like the last half hour of the show, last half hour to 45 minutes. So we could say like around a little after midnight or something like that, I don't know, around 12:30 more or less. But, you know, we'll put the details there so people know, come to the channel. And we'll also try to also announce the winner, not just on HorsePLAY Live, but on the YouTube channel, because I know people don't constantly check bang on the podcast. And yeah, I understand. It's not fair to have to check 2 hours worth of a podcast to see who won.
Right. Well,
so we'll figure out a better way to do that.
And in the future, guys, when we're giving stuff away like this, we'll find a better way to get it out to you guys, like you just said, and an actual a better rolling system on how you guys want to do it. Like, we'll actually put everybody's name in it, and we'll go through it, and then we'll draw the name opposed to a number, and you know. We'll just make sure that everybody, anybody and everybody that wants to know, we're going to make sure all the rules are set specifically because, yes, I'm so sorry that, you know, I didn't set the rules specifically and actually, you know, so that was my fault. But this is the first one. I've given away stuff on, like, my stream before, but I've never given something away like this where it's a 2 or 3 week or 4 week process. So, please, I apologize. I'm trying to find the video right now, and of course I can't, just because.
Video.
Where's it at? Yeah.
Well, that's actually, if you go to the website.
Community Gaming and Events.
If you just go to geekyans.net and you go to the giveaways section, it'll show all our contests and giveaways. And they'll link you to the YouTube channel, so. And Blue's being mischievous. You can see her head a little bit in the shot. She's trying to get the microphone.
I see it.
She's walked away.
All right, we're going to leave a comment right now, guys. Actually, I'm going to do it later because I need to talk on what I'm actually doing.
But BFT says that for him, the big WTF moment, I guess you could say, was when he found out that was the reveal about the major change during Destiny's development, leading to the mess that was the story mode and the content left out for DLC. And, you know, that's a recurring theme in the gaming industry. Just, you know, all this content that's stripped out of the game, either because they underestimate the development cycle or they just decide, oh, we'll just stretch it out and charge more through DLC. So, it's disappointing. I don't know. I've really been on an indie game kick. I like all the free-to-play games and the bargain bin, the sleeper hits. That's the stuff that I've been most excited about. Especially also like with Humble Bundle. Sometimes you find some real gems that you were not expecting to find at all.
Yeah, right. You get like 4 or 5 games that are $40 plus and you get them for like $10.
Yeah, pretty awesome. Much usually you can name your price too. But Lukasia says she's only half paying attention because she's playing Destiny right now, which is funny.
It's all good.
But she says, what game we're giving away? We're giving away Payday 2. Well, Obi's giving away Payday 2. It's up on a GeekyAn's channel, but he's managing that giveaway. So, what we have
and not a very good job either.
But people don't know. There's a lot of giving away something on a Twitch channel is different than like setting up a giveaway on YouTube.